Hello.
So today we're going to talk about Egypt. So a lot of people have asked us, did we feel safe in Egypt? What did we do? Things like that. So that's the big question. Did we feel safe while we were in Egypt?
Kind of.
Why he says that is, yes, we were completely safe, but it was because we had a police escort the whole way. We were a caravan of buses. So basically every single person that wanted to, that got off of the Celestial cruise ship, boarded buses. We went in a caravan that had a police escort everywhere we went in Egypt. We had guides from Egypt. So it was a personal tour and we were very guarded.
Okay, with that said, if we wouldn't have had all that, would we have been as safe? I don't know, but here's what I think. We had, because our convoy was so big, we had targets on our back.
Yes.
Major tourists, right?
Mm-hmm.
A whole bunch of them coming in at one time. So they saw us coming. Mm-hmm. So they hit us, I think, probably a little bit harder than if you would have been in more of a smaller, intimate group. I don't think it would be as bad. I don't think it would have been as aggressive.
Right. So, yeah, we were 1,000 people getting off a ship, boarding buses, and going to these locations in Egypt.
So it's a double-edged sword, mm-hmm. I think. Yes, we were safe. We had the caravans. We had the police escorts. That made us safe, but it also made the vendors more aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
As we were in that caravan, we would see traffic trying to get in between the buses, and the police escorts were not having that.
No.
So there was a lot of like horns blowing the whole trip. It was just the whole kind of experience transporting back and forth was kind of unnerving. They would get into the convoy, regardless of whether the cops were honking at them or trying to shoo them away or not. I mean, it's very aggressive, you know, with that many people.
Mm-hmm.
You tend to get a bit aggressive.
Yeah, there's 25 million people that live in Cairo and Giza. Yeah. We can't wrap our heads around that. I mean, New York is our largest city and it's 8 million people.
Yeah.
So trying to just fathom that many people, you understand why the security needs to be there, because of those 25 million people, most are great people. We are not knocking Egyptian people, but when you've got that kind of numbers, you're gonna have unsavory folks, yeah, anywhere.
The word metropolis doesn't do it justice.
No.
But you can just imagine, with that many people, it's kind of chaotic. We're small town people.
Yeah.
It was kind of unnerving for us. Other people may not find it to be as aggressive as we did, but that's just our personal experience and how we felt. So we're just trying to convey that to you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so then that begs the question, should you go to Egypt? Yes, go to Egypt. Just do it in a tour environment. I would not say Egypt is somewhere that you need to just go, oh, I'm gonna go to Egypt and just book a plane trip and go over there.
Don't freestyle it there.
No, don't freestyle it. There are a lot of, if you wanna really see Egypt, book a land tour. I mean, you can go to Luxor and Cairo, you can do a Nile cruise. There's a lot you can do in Egypt. Just do it safely, do it with a tour, be safe. That's all we're saying.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm gonna say, you know, and I said it in the videos many times that it's a one and done for me. I still kind of feel that way. Like, I feel like I don't need to go back there. It was just intense. And, you know, when you're on vacation, or when I'm on vacation, I don't want to feel tense.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I want to be relaxed and really enjoy the moment. And it was very difficult for me to do that there.
Mm-hmm.
Was it amazing? Yes. It was a spectacle like none other to
Absolutely.
See the pyramids of Giza. It was unbelievable. I think that the experience could have been better had it have been a lot less aggressive from the vendors trying mm-hmm. to sell you things and whatnot. I mean, we could hardly vlog there because we were bombarded with vendors left and right as we were recording. They did not care
yeah.
that we were recording. They wanted our money. So just know that and do your research. Make sure you go with a guided tour. Doesn't have to be a big one, but do your research. Make sure it's safe.
And just to add to what Jason said, you know, we have gotten several comments on our videos when we mention the aggressive vendors. Well, haven't you had aggressive vendors in the Caribbean? Yes, but it's a different situation. In the Caribbean, you can walk past them. Here, you are in this area where you're trying to enjoy the view of the pyramids. You can't get away from them.
Yeah, you're contained within a group environment. You can't leave the group. You're stuck with that group. You're there until that group gets on the bus and continues the tour.
Mm-hmm.
So there was that. Plus, it was just foreign to us. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
We were across the world.
Yes.
Okay, so I think that played a little factor or a big factor in all that as well. And yeah, when you're in the Caribbean, you're in another country as well.
Mm-hmm.
But it just doesn't feel so far removed as it did there for us.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's all those little things that kind of play a little part.
Mm-hmm. Do we recommend you go to Egypt at least once and see the pyramids?
Yeah, go see the pyramids. Do it once, because if you don't, you'll regret it. If you do, you'll just kind of have some things that you didn't like about it as well, but at the end of the day, the payoff is good.
This is the last ancient wonder of the world. It's the last one standing. So definitely go see it. Have your picture taken, have that experience, try and let the outside world not bother you, and just visualize the fact that you're here with these 4,000 plus year old pyramids that were built by hand before any type of machinery was there to lift those stones. I still don't know how they did it. I really don't.
With pulleys. They did it with pulleys.
But my gosh, they had to build the pulleys to get way up.
The moral of the story is, it's worth the headache that you're gonna have a little bit. It's worth the anxiety to be able to say at the end of the day, you got to see that. That's what we're trying to say. So with that said, by all means, go check it out at least once, see for yourself.
Yeah, and if you've been to Egypt and had an experience, let us know how your experience was.
Absolutely.
Okay, till next time.
See you later. Happy cruising.
Bye.